Good morning to everybody. I'm Daniel Magalotti, and this presentation will describe the research activity of the 3 years of the PhD based on the design and characterization of an active personal dosimeter for healthcare application. In this presentation, we give you a brief introduction about the wireless sensor network and healthcare application. Then I'll describe the image sensor, that is the key of our system, and the system architecture implementation. Some experimental characterization, some result of the system, and at the end, some few words about the auxiliary activity, the conclusion, and the scientific publications. So regarding this activity, we want to implement a wireless sensor network of dosimeters. A wireless sensor network is a technology customized in different environments by using different sensors, they are able to create an adaptive and sensitive environment. This sensor can measure the different parameters in the environment and also can record and track the history of the measurements. In particular, we are focused on the healthcare monitoring application, where the wireless sensor network is designed around the human body, and the sensors are used to measure, for example, the healthcare status condition of the user in order to provide a direct real-time feedback to the user. And also this information can be sent to a medical center to detect and react an emergency condition. Depending on the specific application, a wireless sensor network needs to be customized with respect to different parameters. And in my research activity, I am focused on the low-power portable device, create an ad hoc network, and also implement an onboard processing to control the output data of the sensor. The monitoring, the scenario is the interventional audiology procedures, and the attention was focused on the operator instead of the patients, because the medical operator are exposed to a scattered X-ray radiation during their work activity. Currently, the monitoring of the absorbed dose is performed by using passive dosimeters that they cannot provide a real-time measurement of the dose. And so in order to reduce the total amount of absorbed dose, the unnecessary dose absorbed by the operators, some active personal dosimeters are available on the market that they can provide a real-time measurement of the dose and dose rate. But in the Oramed project in the 2011, these devices are analyzed and some limitations have been highlighted. Then, in this context, we want to implement a network of dosimetric system based on a commercial image sensor to monitor in real time the absorbed dose of the medical operator. The system requirements are real time monitoring of the dose, offline storage of the dose measurements, the accuracy better than 10%, that is the actual accuracy of the passive dosimeters, portable device and low power consumption. The system architecture is the following. The dosimeters are worn by the operator in different parts of the body, and in particular on the hand, that are not that are the most part of the body exposed to the X-ray radiation. And the sensor is able to detect the X-ray photons. The output of the sensor is received by a digital signal processing unit which implements a data reduction algorithm to extract two observables correlated to the dosimetric quantities. These observables are received by a microcontroller that sent wireless to a remote station by using the simplicity protocol. The observable find by the digital signal processing unit. So first of all, I have characterized the sensor. And in particular, the sensor consists has 300,000 pixels. So each pixel is analyzed, and the sensor is characterized when exposed to an X-ray photons. When the sensor receives, when the X-ray photons interact with the sensor, it generates a cloud of charge. And this cloud of charge is collected by more than one pixel. The central pixel of the cluster is the seed, and that collect the higher value of the photon energy, and the adjacent pixel collect a fraction of the total photon energy. So, a cluster identification algorithm has been considered to find the observables correlated to the dosimetric quantities. This cluster algorithm, find in the literature, consists of the following steps. As first, we evaluate the pedestal and the noise distribution of the all pixel in the sensor frame. Then we normalize each pixel, and we compare each pixel with a primary threshold to identify the number of photons in a frame, and with a secondary threshold to identify the cluster signal contribution. And these two observables are correlated to the photon energy and to the absorbed dose. But in order to implement this algorithm in a modern programmable device, it requires a lot of memory resources to store all the pedestal and the noise value for each pixel, and also a lot of digital processing resources to implement the divider operation, the normalization of each pixel. And the algorithm is not compatible with the real-time requirement, the low-power requirement of the system. Then a simplified algorithm has been developed, and that consists of just one threshold, and we compare the absolute threshold with raw data of the pixel, and these two new observables are the number of pixels in a frame and the sum of the signals of the reconstructed pixel in a frame. And also, these two observables are still correlated to the dosimetric quantities, and the performances of these two algorithms is the same. So we don't lose information by considering just a number of just these two new observables. And this algorithm can be easily implemented in a complex programmable logic device. And in this slide, we can see the schematic diagram of the firmware. It consists just of one comparator with the absolute threshold and the counters that collect the two thresholds. And also, we use two global counters that collect the total amount of dose for each medical procedures, and is used at the end of the acquisition to recover the wireless losses of the wireless interface. The losses of the wireless interface. This is the firmware of the microcontroller that receives these two observables that send wireless to a remote station. The wireless protocol is the Simplicity protocol, and this microcontroller can work in two frequency bands, in the European bands and the American frequency band. A dedicated acquisition system has been designed that controls the data acquired by the system, so the user can list the available dosimeters on the network, can control the start and the stop of the acquisition, and two graphs monitor in real time the data recorded by each dosimeter. And each dosimeter can be configured at the start of the acquisition, so the threshold can be, we can calibrate, so we can find the absolute threshold, and also the sensor register can be programmed. Then I have designed three different prototypes with the aim to improve the power consumption and the portability of the system. With the prototype 1, we improved the power consumption in order to be compatible with the 8 consecutive hours of operating time. Then we study how to, I study how to improve the portability of the system, and the dipole antenna has been replaced by using a cheap antenna that is very small. And also, I have studied the interaction with the human body, so the, how the human body affects the antenna performances. And we have seen that a distance greater than 1.5 centimeter, the performances of the antenna are not affected. Finally, the final prototype integrates all the components inside a single board. We have the sensor, the CPLD, the microcontroller, the antenna, and the four prototypes are built to create the dosimeter networks. Then the sensor and the system have been characterized in laboratory by exposing to a X-ray source, in open space by evaluating the losses of the wireless interface, and also in operating room. In this few slides, I concentrate with the results in the operating room, and the two experimental setups have been considered, the network with two prototypes and the network with four prototypes. So we compare the packet error rate, the losses of the wireless interface, the mean value of the packet error rate for the network with four prototypes is a little bit higher than the network with two prototypes, but the losses are acceptable and also can be recovered at the end of the acquisition. Then I study the synchronization of the prototypes with the X-ray burst. As we can see in these two figures, both the two networks are synchronized, the prototypes of the two networks are synchronized with respect to each other and with the X-ray bars, so the signals and the no signals. And the system can be used to monitor can be used to perform a real-time monitoring of the absorbed dose. Then I study the average signal associated to each pixel over threshold by considering the ratio between the two observables, the energy and the number of pixels, and by considering the mean value of the distribution, we convert this mean value in photon energy, and we can see in this graph that as function of different interventional radiology procedures, the mean value associated to each pixel over threshold are constant, and it does not depend on different acquisition systems. So the performances of the sensor are not affected by the acquisition system. And finally, we compare with passive dosimeters. First, we calibrate our system and the passive dosimeter in a certified center. And for all the medical procedures, we apply the calibration factor, and we found that all the system lie in the around this the line with the slope equal to 1. So it means that our system and the passive dosimeter measure the same amount of dose. And the precision of our system is better than the precision of the TLD, because this is the error bar of the TLD, while the error bar of our system is hidden by the point. And the system can be used to measure the total amount of dose. Then we compare with the other system, and we are able to resolve some problem issued by the in the Oramed conference, and in some parameters we are comparable with the other device and even better, especially in the energy range. Okay, now some few words about the auxiliary activity that is based on design dedicated hardware processor for high energy physics at CERN. At CERN there is a large hadron collider, and the problem is to increase the event selection after two particles collide in this Large Hadron Collider and in the collider. And in order to increase the event selection, we want to use the information of the tracks. In order to use the information of the tracks, a very fast system need to be developed with a global latency about 3.6 microseconds. And this hardware processor consists of a combination of two technologies, the associative memory chip that is a custom chip, and using the modern programmable device, the FPGA. The track selection algorithm consists of two sequential steps. In the first step, the associative memory chip receives the coordinate of the particles, and it implements a pattern matching operation to find the low resolution tracks. After, these low resolution tracks are sent back to the FPGA, and the FPGA implements a fitting algorithm to find the high resolution tracks inside the low resolution tracks. All the functionality are implemented inside a single PCB board. This board has 14 metal layers, and the FPGA is able to manage up to 8 gigabit per second for the input and the output link, and up to gigabit per second from the link to and from the associative memory chip. All the functionality of the board of this board has been validated, and also is the firmware integration, and also we want to integrate the firmware inside the FPGA. Then, in conclusion, regarding the main activity, the commercial CMOS image sensor is a candidate for portable dosimetric system. The final version of the prototype has been produced as a part of wireless dosimeter networks, and the final prototype has been validated in the operating room during several interventional radiological procedures with performances comparable to passive dosimeters. As future works, a compact version of the system can be designed by integrating both the sensor and the algorithm inside a ASIC in order to reduce also the dimension of the system, and dosimetric studies can be performed to correlate the absorbed dose with respect to the operator activity and with respect to different part of the different part of the body, and also with respect to different type of medical procedures. This is a list of the scientific publications divided in journals and international conferences. Thank you for your attention.
Thanks for your talk. Any question?